Labyrinth, come in.
Cause I make you ugly. As soon as it drops, we're on a rampage. Bubbles popping up before you know it. There's rubble in the cause we'll be pushing it up. Somebody say, you better run, yeah. What up, boys and girls? Welcome back to my channel. How are we all doing? Today I'm gonna continue where I left off last time. I was reading the new things that are gonna happen in Assassin's Creed 3, or that already known that leaked by Ubisoft. So, and I'm gonna go further where I left off last time. And the first thing I'm gonna read here. Oh yeah, let's say something about this match I'm playing. I'm apparently this is an old match, or an old match. I think it's a month old or something. And it's a normal dead match. And I'm trying out. I see morph and smoke bomb. So if you wanna enjoy the match, it's all about that. I think. And I'm not even gonna get a bad score here, but I'm not gonna talk about the match too much. Let's go back to the thing that interests us the most, and that's the new Assassin's Creed team. And I also had some questions about, let's say, the multiplayer, and it's confirmed there will be a multiplayer in the next Assassin's Creed, so that's good. And yes, let's go to the new things on the list. The first thing it says is the Brotherhood, or Assassin's Guild, will return in some form. Definitely than we have seen before, but it will return, it seems. Well, that's not a bad thing. I think it's a good thing, because I like that. We have trained them, and maybe it's gonna be different. Of course it's gonna be different, because we have a new persona. But I like the whole idea, the whole concept of it. And this is also a thing I like. There will be no more mercenaries, thieves, courtesans, or Romani. Or other factions, for that matter. And there will no be replacement for them. So, there will be a replacement for them, but something completely different. So, not sure about that, because I think it's gonna be a little bit too easy. Like, it was all too easy, if you ask me. I liked it more when, like, back in the days in Assassin's Creed 1, it was really relied on stealth, really relied on, yeah, you know, you have to, you couldn't run into it, because, yeah, you were discovered and it was all blown. And, yeah. I don't know. I like the stealth more, the idea of stealth more than the idea of too easy. So, the next thing, the den defense. It will not return. I think that's one thing. Yeah, it's kind of good. I liked it, to be honest. I'm one of the only guys I've seen in the community who really liked it. But it, well, yeah, I thought it was a funny game. It was a fun mini game, let's say that. But on the other hand, it was kind of annoying. Every time you get your meter full, you need them to defend. So it was pretty annoying. So you have to really pay attention to your meter. You have to constantly go to the heralds and shit. So that was a pretty annoying part. So that's good about taking it out, I think. And the next thing I'm reading is, wanted to be jump on a point, new player. No, that's not interesting. This is interesting. The new hero is called Connor. Already told that. Oh yeah, and it says the it's pronounced Wadunhagedol. So I'm not even sure if I pronounced that right. It says completely the name here, but I can't say it. I'm sorry about that. And it also says he has an English father and a Native American mother. So here we are. That's what I saw in his face. He looked like a Native American. So that's what it says. More details about the protagonist scenarios. You will experience Connor's childhood on the American frontier, and as he is raised by the Mohawk. The Mohawk eventually clash with white colonists who burn their village down, causing Connor to dedicate his life to confront tyranny and injustice. So it's kind of like the story of Ezio, that it's mostly based on revenge. So that's not a bad thing. A new travel approach that has players leaping and climbing trees and mountain cliffs. That's what we've seen in the trailer. I was like running to the trees and all that stuff. All that good stuff, I gotta say. Uses a new version of Anvil Engine that can depict thousands of troops engaged in bloody battle, along with highly detailed face close-ups. It's kind of like, I don't know, you've seen those games, the bigger games with all those. I never played them with all those army guys, you know. It kind of sounds like a mini game, but I don't know. It sounds good. Judging by the images, the faces really are quite good. So, okay, I agree with that. Combat is focused on putting you on the offense and based on speed and momentum. I really like the timing part in that. I like in the very first game it was believed you can good like good counter kill in Assassin's Creed 1, and I was constantly based on timing, of only based on timing, and I love that shit. The main character has thousands of new unique animations, no carryover from other titles, so it's gonna be completely new and unique style, so that's awesome to support the new combat system. Character details: George Washington, the first one. Interacting with Washington is one of the core relationships of the games, so that's kind of like Leonardo da Vinci, kind of, I don't know. Oh no, the next one says Benjamin Franklin. He's not a convenient event a la Da Vinci, but he kind of has to be. I don't know for sure what I'm gonna do with him, but it's also, yeah, it's all cool. And Charles Lee, I don't know that guy. I have no idea who he is. His role is a mystery, so it doesn't say anything about him. So that's that. The game is set between the years 1753 and 1783, and it's centered around the city of Boston and New York. Already covered that part. It's not just going to the historical building now, it's going to a historical event. That's a quote, I don't know. For example, you will see the Great Fire of New York, you will visit Valley Forge as a location that is currently occupied by Washington forces. You will visit these places in the moment that they were important, and hopefully experience the reason why we know where we are today. At least that's the goal. The next thing, Connor is the heart of major battles, and they can now have a couple of thousand guys on screen, whatever before it was capped at about 100. So that's, yeah, multiplied 10, so that's kind of interesting how that will turn out. They have to put a whole other engine in, I think. I have no idea how game development works, but it kind of sounds very interesting. The overall story is still centered around the Assassins versus the Templar and Connor's journey. Kind of like the previous Assassin's Creed, as you will. Not all the colonists will be cast as good people, and not all British will cast as evil opposers. They're trying to focus on how both the Assassins and Templar viewpoints exist in grey morality, and the Templars really believe that they're saving the world. So it's kind of like the same story as before. It's really the Templars against Assassins, and nothing to do with nationality whatsoever. Kind of like in real life, you're bad or you're a good guy. Simple as that. The French and Native Americans will also feature in the game, and was probably really obvious. Yeah, that was really obvious. The modern day stuff releases to the location of New York and the end of Revelation. There will be a source of wilderness in the game referred to as the Frontier. The map of the Frontier is 1.5 times bigger than the entire map of Brotherhood, so that's awesome. That game is gonna be so huge, I have no idea. Kinda sounds like Skyrim already, but... The Frontier is not empty like in Assassin's Creed 1, but features a third of game missions and gameplay content. I have no exactly idea what that means, to be honest, so if you can help me with that. Oh, here again, over the animals. You can hunt animals for resources, and how you kill them affects your reward. A one-hit kill on the bear gets you much more valuable pelt than stabbing it 8 times. So that seems fair, but also kind of like a minigame. Killing bears, awesome. The wilderness travels plays a big part in the gameplay in the Frontier, allowing you to use trees, cliff, ledges and more to set up kills and end combat. So that sounds awesome again. Connor does have a hidden blade, as we knew already. The world changes as time passes, so a field where a battle happened in 1 year may just be a series of empty encampments a few months later. So that's also pretty epic. It's gonna be like if there's a war, and a few months later, you know, you see the graves there and shit. That's gonna be awesome. Kinda sounds harsh what I'm saying. I'm not a harsh person, but you know what I mean. If you see the effects afterwards. In the winter, soldiers will move slowly and stumble about in the snow. That's what we talked about in the previous video, what I really, really like. Just the effects of the weather. And takes and rivers will freeze and allowing you to go new places. Oh, that's interesting. This gives Connor an extra advantage since he can still use the trees and wilderness pretty effectively during this time of year. So there you get your advantage against the soldiers, against the guards. There are a lot sorts of clubs and groups who want you to join and give you quests. These are separate from the mission system. So that's kind of a separate thing, kind of like the Thief Faction's missions before, I think. These clubs will contract you based on what you do in the game. For example, hunting a lot will give you invention in the hunting society. So if you're gonna steal a lot, you're gonna compete like with the thieves or something. They are not in the game, like I mentioned before, but something like that, I guess. So I'm gonna leave it at this, I think, because I'm at the end of the match. So I hope you enjoyed these things I covered, and I will bring you the next things I'm gonna cover in the next video. I think in the next video I will fit all the questions with all the new things that are in this article. And yeah, I hope I will see you next time, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one, and please hit the like button, please hit the subscribe button, and till next time, peace out.